have an open mind about it.
Well, exactly, and that's also why I kind of am so interested in many of the new scientific discoveries, because in many cases they kind of deconstruct what we thought previously about reality, basically, and even about the human being or consciousness that we have been talking about here now. And it seems to me that in any case, whatever viewpoint we have in it, in our baggage, so to speak, if it's religious or only scientific or what have you, it tends to show a very interesting picture that either leads us up to the point of what we talk about here today, a program reality, or that there's some kind of weirdness going on, in the sense that things are not at all what we perceive them to be. Many people, I guess, will put in the idea of God there. They also come from a religious background or what have you. But in any case, what it says to me is that we're learning a heck of a lot of who we are, where we're going, and where of where we might end up if we continue with this, with the development of the science. And I just hope personally that the close-mindedness of things is something that slowly will kind of disintegrate, if you will, that people will discover, I at least have discovered, wonderful things about what the human being is and what life is about, just by observing the new scientific discoveries. And hopefully this is something that will continue this trend, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, absolutely. And, it's there's a big difference between the way Western education treats some of these things and Eastern education treats some of these things.
Yes.
Ideas like, energy centered of the body are well understood and respected in Eastern cultures and not so much in Western cultures. And both parties can't be right. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, I think having an open mind about a lot of these things is really important. And it's real easy to do one of two things. Either accept what has been proven as the only, group or category of things that really exist, or just do some hand-waving and say, oh, it must be a god that, that's in control of all of this. Those are sort of two extremes of how people deal with these kinds of questions.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a little bit more in the middle, where I say, I'm going to just be extremely open-minded, and I can imagine, there's not an anomaly that I have ever heard that I can't imagine an answer for. Mm-hmm. So if I can imagine an answer for it that even follows sort of the rules that I know about computation, about, our reality, then it's possible.
Yes, absolutely, and I think it's it gives us another perspective on life, even the basic outlook of it, or on life. I think that if we incorporate the idea of a program reality, that will the general idea that things are, the seriousness of it all doesn't mean that things become just a joke or whatever. That's not what I'm saying, but I'm saying that the seriousness of life can be perceived somewhat differently if we think about it, that this is, we're in a computer game, basically, in that sense. It might be very scary to some, obviously, in that way too, but I feel that this is something that might be necessary for many people at this point to step back for a little while and question what the whole thing is, just that, because to skip some of the narrow-mindedness that many people are, kind of suffering from today in that sense. And hopefully this is a view that will help to contribute to that, open people up, basically,
Yeah, thank you. I agree. I agree 100%.
Okay, Jim, why don't we, begin here to round things off with this time. Again, the book is The Universe Solved, and it's a really, really, really interesting hypothesis and idea. And I know that you bring up a lot of different theories and evidence to suggest that this is the case, that we're living in a programmed reality, of course. Why don't you go ahead and mention your website again for us, so people can go there, and also how we would go about getting a copy of your book.
Sure, thank you. The website is called theuniversesolved.com, The Universe Solved, exactly the way it sounds, and I'm sure it'll be linked up there on Red Ice Creations as well. The book can be purchased directly on the website if you live in the United States. It can be purchased through Amazon, Barnes & Noble, tried to build the site to be very interactive. We have polls on this site, so you can take polls where you you can put in your thoughts about time travel or extraterrestrial life or whatever. There are articles on there about, you know, the ideas that we've talked about tonight. There are also links to other sites that explore the same ideas. I have a blog, but probably one of the most interesting parts of the site is the forum. So there's a section there where people can just join up and, you know, explore, you know, whatever ideas they want. We have categories on philosophy and transhumanism and singularities, anomalies, you know, scientific and technology categories on AI, cosmology, nanotech, quantum mechanics, robotics, gaming. And, you know, it's open to just sort of general queries as well. So there's a lot of information there. There are news links for a lot of these areas and, you know, a lot of interactivity. And we mentioned the powers of 10. And the other thing I'd like to mention, too, is there's a, you know, what's called a chat bot, or basically an artificial intelligence on there named Morpheus. And you can log in and talk to him and share your thoughts about him through some polls, and can write to me and tell me what you think as well. So a lot to explore on the website, and we're adding to it all the time.
Brilliant. TheUniverseSolved.com. Go there, check it out. A lot of information up there for you. Jim, thank you very much again for coming on. It's been really interesting, as always, and we hope to have you back again, and keep up the great work, okay?
Thank you very much, Henrik. It was a pleasure, and keep up the good work on your site, too. I love your site as well.
Thank you very much. That's our program with Jim Elvidge. We'll talk more on Thursday with you and Lynn Marsouli about his new book, The Alien Interviews. In the meantime, take good care, and we'll see you online.